Our next speaker is Ashish Dubey. Ashish Dubey is the head of business development in MapMy India, one of the largest mapping companies of India. And he's here to shed some light on how the company is forging amazing business relations with its customers to deliver world-class data and mapping experience with its users.
Hello, everyone. Hope the day has been great for everyone over here. And I know I'm between you and the coffee break, right? So I promise I'll keep this short and simple, right? So I'm not sure if you guys have heard about MapMy India, but we are one of the largest local player in Indian market, right? So before I start with the presentation, I'll just give a quick background about myself. So my name is Ashish, and I'm leading a business development at MapMy India. And so MapMy India is not just a mapping player, but also a location-based technology company. And we power a lot of OEM companies, right? A lot of e-commerce, right? And right. So that is our vision. We want to make our world better through maps and location. And our mission is to create the best technologies in the location space. So a little intro about MapMy India, that it was founded in 1992. We are... Okay. Am I audible to you? Okay. Yeah. So we have been founded in 1992, and we are powering almost more than 200 million customers, and we have 5,000 plus enterprises. Right, we are headquartered in New Delhi, and we have regional offices in Bangalore, Mumbai, and then we have a spread across other small tier one and tier two cities. So, as you can see on the screen, that we have the investors, Flipkart, Qualcomm, and Zenrin. So this is a map evolution for us. So we were the first company to launch a digital map in this country. That was early 2000. And we were also the first company to give access of a map through web, right? And again, that was in, I think, 2005, when we launched our own mapping portal, maps.mapmyindia.com. And then we were pioneer in the navigation space when we launched turn-by-turn navigation. And then that is how our journey started. So we launched our 3D maps, of course, for the telecom, or for the 5G or 6G planning. And then live maps, which is, again, a traffic map, which gives you a traffic experience, right? And then there's a panoramic, which is similar to a street view, which helps helps you know us a lot by collecting a lot of point of interest, roads, and other attributes. And then the last two things are which we are doing a prototype with a lot of our partners in the OEM space. So we have created ADAS data sets and the real digital wheel. So this is really interesting. So how we are, you know, helping the citizens of the country. So we have partnered with ISRO, and we have launched a Navic app, right, which basically helps the fishermen of the country, right? And how does this help? It just show them that, you know, like when the fishermen are on the when they are in sea, and when they are not able to find, like, you know, what is the borderline or how much kilometers they are, like, so it just gives some alerts to them, right? Hey, that you're gonna cross the borderline, so you need to be alert, you need to go back, something like this. So this is something which we have been, you know, partnership with ISRO, and then that is how we are helping them. Map spectrum, so as you can see, from GIS vector, then value-added map data, 3D maps, real view, which is similar to street view, We have done a lot of things in the map, by providing a 2D maps, by providing 3D maps, indoor viewer. And then we have also started working on regional vernacular data by providing data in the Hindi language and then some languages from the southern part, some Punjabi, Marathi, right? And of course the traffic, then there's the navigation. So this navigation is the offline app, which we call as a Navi map, right? And then there's again ADAS and HD maps. Okay, so as you know that India is, it's very challenging to map the country, right? Because it's full of different cultures, regions, and you can see there's a lot of problems that, you know, while we map the country. So these are some challenges that we faced while mapping India. So of course, we do not have any standard mapping policy. There's lack of official records, poor planning, low infra quality, right? So how we plan this, right? How we make a map, a more detailed map? By making, you know, strategizing in such a way that, you know, we deployed a team, not only the city, but going into the locality, right? And every locality has some like 3-4 people and they've started mapping it. So we have maintained map release for last 14 years by providing 4 updates annually, which again, recently we have moved to update of every 2 months. And then there were some challenges in road network. So this is very important because we provide a navigation, right? So we want to make sure which class of road is a motorable road or which is a bi-lane or you know, a bike lane, right? So as you can see, there's a lot of unpaved roads. And when we launched a navigation app in 2005, right, it actually helped the consumer to navigate from point A to point B, and we are the first one to launch this. This is an interesting address structure. And how we, identify that how the urban address structure is written or how the rural address structure is written. I think we have processed around millions of records to come to conclusion of writing these type of addresses, right? And like you see for the urban, like we go all the level to house number, and in village side we go to the village point level. Then there's a real view, and we just collect this data so that, you know, help us, you know, to provide some good road attributes, point of attributes, right? And not just that, but it also helps, you know, to identify the heights of the hoardings, the height of flyover, which actually, you know, kind of a turn restrictions, which becomes a part of road. Whether, you know, if truck can pass with certain height or something like that. We also manage transit data for almost like 30 cities, right? And we are increasing to other tier 2 cities also. So this is something interesting, one map that we have launched, which again, similar to what you have a Google map, right? It gives you navigation. It gives you analytics, gives you map, shows you multiple views. So I have attached some screenshots, so maybe you guys can, you know, download from the App Stores or Google Play. Yeah, I think I just missed some slides. It's not here. Okay, I can speak about that. Okay, so while collecting this map data, like, you know, we wanted to give access to a lot of our enterprise users, to a lot of consumers. So that is where when we launched our APIs, right? So we have a stack of APIs of from geocoding, reverse geocoding, to write, and then how we are powering and how we are helping the consumers and the businesses of the country by providing them access to our services. And like, if I had to give you an example, PhonePe is the one which, if you guys have the application, you might see in the store section that how Map India has, you know, powered that particular service where, you know, you can identify which vendor, you know, accepts the PhonePe, right? So that is how we have helped on the business side. And on the consumer side, so we have, when I say consumer, which means it also includes the developer side, where we have a freemium plan, right? So we have also given a freemium plan which has some X number of transactions they can do on a daily basis, just to understand our APIs. I'm sorry guys, I have just missed some slides. So do you guys have any questions for me? I'm done, yeah. Yeah, so we have planned like, so mid-2019 is our plan when we want to get into the Southeast Asia region, and that is where we are planning to use the OSMs. Like for India, we already have the our own, you know, tiles and database. We have our own IP, but of course, like 2019 is a plan when we'll be using OSM for the Southeast Asia region.
More questions?
So there are two things. One, we have, of course, the people on ground who, you know, who keep on collecting this data. In fact, three things, right? Second is about the probes, right? So Map India is also into a lot of you know, IoT space, right? So we get a lot of probes, and that helps us, you know, to identify the road networks, turn restrictions, and, you know, the road attributes, basically, right? And third thing is that we also use a lot of change detection APIs. Right, which we basically sources from the, you know, the satellite imagery providers. So that is how we are able to maintain our data sets.
So if there is redundancy of data or after a maybe buffer period, okay, then or is it a never-ending process for you? You'll just keep on taking up new data and keep updating. How do you deal with that?
Okay, so I think I can just put it into two different ways. So there are some layers which we don't need to go and, you know, collect the data. Like, for example, road networks, right? So for the road networks, we have already covered 6 million road networks. And we believe that nothing is beyond that, right? Unless some new thing or something is coming up in rural area, right? When I say 6 million, it is a mix of paved and unpaved roads, right? And then we categorize which is a motorable road or which is non-motorable road, which are the bike lanes, you know? So we collect, right? I think, and yeah, and then the other layer is address. We need to keep on, you know, adding those data at this point, because at this stage, if I say we have address house number data for 240 cities, right? But that is not, you know, that is not covering the entire country, right? So that is, again, a continuous process. And the third thing is point of interest, which now we are sitting at almost like, what, 30 million plus point of interest, but we believe there's a lot of point of interest. Interest which are adding. What the best part is that we have managed, we have maintained those point of interest into a set of 200 categories, right? But yeah, these are the continuous process. And the fourth thing is land use. Again, land use we don't require, because hardly there's, you know, any new constructions happening around. Yeah. Okay, so so when you say static, do you mean on the traffic side? Okay, so for rural we do not have, only for the urban areas we have, and that too we do not have for all the major cities, but top 10 cities. Like for example, like for Mumbai has a lot of, you know, small localities, right? So we have those data, and when we take a reference of 2011 census data, right, and then there's a team who keep on, you know, churning the data and getting some real-time outputs. And also we work with a lot of retail, you know, retail companies, Right. So we also get a lot of data from them. So we just collect those data and then, you know, we just keep on updating those, which is also a mix of affluence data as well.
I'm sure Ashish will be here. And now there is a tea break, so it's a perfect time to talk while having tea and coffee. So yes, it's a tea break. We'll be back at 4:30. We'll have the next set of sessions. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.